Black hair, round glasses, lightning bolt scar. Everybody knows what Harry Potter looks like, and this watercolor is where it all began. This watercolor is Thomas Taylor's original illustration for Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. The world's conception of Harry Potter, from books to film to merchandise, started here. In 1996, Thomas Taylor, as a student fresh out of art school, went to the Bloomsbury offices in London and submitted some drawings. Barry Cunningham, who was a Bloomsbury publisher, paired the then unknown artist with the then unknown author, J.K. Rowling, and this was the result. This is the famous scene where Harry sees the Hogwarts Express for the first time. One thing that's very interesting about the watercolor is that you actually see more than you do on the cover of the published novel. So in addition to platform 9 3/4, we also see platform 10. We see more of Harry's muggle clothing that's very rumpled and a little bit oversized. And I think what's extraordinary is we also see more of the plume that's emanating from the Hogwarts Express. It's pretty clear that Taylor thought that the title would be placed there, and it was, but in a more graphic design sort of way. One point of interest is Harry's scarf. It's red and yellow, which are clearly Gryffindor colors, but at this point in the novel, he hasn't been to Hogwarts yet, and he hasn't been sorted into a house. This is a great moment of foreshadowing, perhaps consciously done on Taylor's part, where we see this scarf that would be so much a part of Harry's character and journey throughout the rest of the novels. There's the old cliche that you shouldn't judge a book by its cover, but in this instance, you really probably should.